Why did you go and decide to leave Daisy's mother? Dad was bad enough, but now, you geez, what are you guys going to do for me?
I admit, things got out of hand rather quickly, but that obviously wasn't my intention, Luigi. I figure you were so worried about your father and Richard that maybe you wouldn't have minded if I helped fix the situation myself.
What? No. Where did you get an idea like that? Okay. Well, can you maybe fix this problem?
Sorry, I just can't.
Why not?
Look, I usually let things slide, like those overalls for instance. But this? I just didn't like how she was implying that your father doesn't have a mind of his own and such. So know what? I'm not caving in. She can apologize to me instead. I really don't blame your father for pretending to be ill just to leave that place.
Wait, he said he was ill? Please don't tell me he said it was S.
I'm afraid he did.
Yes, he was. He said this about the Queen Marion. Do you know how many times he told this to the public royalty? He mentioned Jess. So appropriate.
Meh, seems appropriate to me. They're both a couple of old farts anyways.
Ouch, I gotta admit, that was a good one. You got a point from me, Louise. Sorry, Luigi.
So, Regina's gonna help this time around, huh? I'm going to rip those books apart with my teeth. Stress ball, maybe?
Huh?
One sec.
Hello?
The help. Our parents got into a thing. The fighting.
Yeah, I know. They're over right now telling me about it. Vaguely, anyways.
Oh, this is an idea. What are we going to do?
I don't know. I'm just trying to understand the situation first.
I just understand they're just being stubborn and taking jobs at each other. How are we gonna come down about these?
They're a pain, I know. But I can't exactly chew their faces now, can I? If I start getting worked up, it won't help solve the problem.
I think I'll come over and talk this over with them. My parents died anyway, so...
No, maybe just let me take care of it.
Daisy, I...
Just don't worry about it. Luigi, look, I gotta go now. I'll talk to you later.
Okay. Don't worry. You gotta be kidding me. How can I not worry? I listened to you about dinner and now I want me to sit here. This makes me feel so small. You get Daisy. I don't need her help. I handle this myself. Man to man. Daisy, it's your sweater vest. I'll sit up there and I see. That's hilarious. Tell me, do you have a seat at a comedy club at the shift? Touché. So, then what's your business here today?
I came here to see King Richard.
Really? Well, alright, Luke, Granny. I doubt you'll have a good time.
Oh, I'm well aware of that. Thanks.
There you are, Your Majesty. Perfect timing as usual. You have a surprise visitor for the evening.
Who is it?
The name escapes me, sir, but he wears green and is of the plumbing trade.
Hey, Richie. Okay, so about that. Are you using that? How about Rich?
Nope. Rick? Try again.
Scared of my own image. Scared of my own immaturity. Scared of my own
What? I mean, Richard. Can you, Richard, make things hard? No, no.
That's better. Better. Don't bring you here, lad.
I couldn't talk to him the other night with my father.
He sobbed you since your mother. Therefore, that, already, so much into my life. Urgent. What about the whole thing? Oh, no, his secret. And whatnot, of course. She sugared, put it all for you.
No, no, she just does seem to have pity me.
Temperature's dropping. Temperature's dropping. I'm not sure if I can.
Look, sorry. Look, lad. What the internet?
Ah, say no more. Sir, I'm aware that you had, that you two had a disagreement on something. It's like a nasty cold. I was healed in on everything.
Oh, so you know then?
Indeed, I do.
You seem to be taking it well. People usually get offended.
Offended? Nah. You know how many times I've heard that sort of thing. I'm a sweet sir. It's a nothing new.
Interesting.
However, what I'm not too keen on is how my dad handled the situation. You see, over the years he lost more and more patience. Where at times a simple conversation turned to an unnecessary bicker war. My mother had to tell me about what happened because he honestly forgot.
Wait, what? Then how is he
set? Well, he was, and now he's just embarrassed.
Really, man?
Well, yeah, I mean, how could he face you when he doesn't remember the fight? It's happened before, too. He always just woke up. He either completely missed the point or forgotten what the problem was. So at this point, me and my brother just cave in and let him have his way, or else he's going to go in circles. But anything, this is why I figured I should explain things to you.
I know didn't really do a good job earlier.
And well, me and my dad would hate if you were to lose a friendship over this. Also, let's keep this between us, okay? He wouldn't be too happy that we were fighting his battles for him.
Oh, sure, of course.
So basically, he just had a whole mess signs of other night with that ego and all. He did get out of the line. That's because he felt his opinion was not being heard. Time to change, Dad. He may show that he's all rough and tough, but he's kind of sensitive too.
Wow, that's so unlike you.
I know, right? He even cried on my shoulder because he was upset with the situation. And I had a little bit of trouble on that one.
I'm amazed how well you've taken this, Luigi. I thought you would be, well, upset. But I guess if you are fine, maybe I'll overreact.
Dad, give me some credit here. I can handle things. Mistakes happen, but what's important is your friendship.
I guess you're right.
I still think we should have gotten an apology in person. It was very rude of them.
I agree, but you and Dad should just take the higher road here. They have a different way of thinking, but as long as things are cleared up, we're good. Do you think Lily wanted to get dragged into this?
Well, no, but... go finish up making dinner. Come help me with the table, Marco.
Okie dokie, Mumsy. Smells good, by the way. Really? Yes. Really, it's hard to imagine someone crying on your soldier. If they would fix things themselves, they wouldn't have to nudge, now would it? Ba-bombed away, Reed.
It's nice seeing you again, Marco. Toadsworth had a wonderful time the other day. That he couldn't go without a second visit.
As I'm sure it keeps him out of your hair. As well, if you like, you and Mario should come by our place with me. Spend some time in New York.
Already ahead of you, Derek. I'm holding Mario to that. Oh, by the way, we invited a special guest for you.